Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss about major application areas of embedded system and purpose of embedded systems. Okay, first one, major application areas. The major application areas are listed here. They are consumer electronics, household appliances, home automations and security systems, automotive industry, telecommunication, computer peripherals, computer networking system, measurements and instrumentation, healthcare, banking and retailing, card readers. Okay. Now we'll see the example for each area. In consumer electronics, the examples we can say is cameras, camcorders, household appliances, televisions, DVD players, washing machines, microwave oven, home automation and security system applications we can say is fire alarms, air conditioner, smoke and gas detector, automotive industry, ABS, anti-lock braking system, engine control, automatic navigation system, then in telecommunication, cellular telephones and all multimedia applications, computer peripherals like printers, scanners, fax machines, computer networking systems, networking routers, switches, hubs, firewalls we can say, healthcare, all types of scanners, ECG, EEG, then measurements and instrumentations, digital CRO, digital multimeter, logic analyzers, all these things we can say, banking and retailing, ATM, automated teller machine, and currency counters we can say, card readers, barcode reader and smart card reader, all these examples we can say for each area. Next one is purpose of embedded system. See, every embedded system is designed to serve the purpose of any of the following tasks. It may be data collection, storage or representation, data communication or data processing, monitoring, controlling or application specific user interface. So first we'll see what is this data collection, storage, representation. The term data, it refers all kind of information like voice, text, image, video or any electrical signal or any measurable quantities, okay? And this data can be either analog or digital. Analog means continuous signal or digital means discrete signal. So these data collections can be done for storage purpose or analysis purpose, manipulation, or it can be transmitted. So these, whatever we are collecting, whatever the data is collected here, may be stored or processed, or it may be deleted after giving some meaningful representation. Example, the best example of an embedded system with the data collection, storage, representation is digital camera. So this camera will capture the image, and this image will be stored inside the memory of the camera, and the captured image will be represented or delivered to the user through the LCD display. No? Second one, data communication. The embedded applications with the data communication functionality is used in various kind of applications like complex satellite communication system to simple home networking system. But in data communication, the transmission of data can be achieved either by wireline medium or wireless medium. And this data collecting embedded system terminal itself can incorporate with data communication units like wireless modules or wireline modules. Wireless modules, examples we can say Bluetooth, ZigBee, Wi-Fi, GPRS, everything. Wireline modules we can say RS-232C, TCP-IP, that examples we can see for wireline modules. Now the embedded application for data with data communication is network router. Actually, they are acting as mediator in data communication, which provides functionality like security, monitoring and all. Next one is data processing. So as I said, data may be in any form. It may be text or image or video, electrical signal or any measurable quantities. Whatever it may be, the collected data by an embedded system may be used for various kind of data processing. Okay, so embedded applications which supports data processing can be used for this purpose. So these devices can be involved in signal processing, like video speech therapy, speech coding, audio video coding synthesis. For this purpose we can use this kind of embedded applications. So now the example of an embedded system with the data processing is a digital hearing aid. So this device will receive the signal, and the received data or signal will be amplified and it will be given to the user. So here the processing is amplification. Fourth one is monitoring. Almost all the embedded applications which comes under the medical domain are used for monitoring only. Example, we can say ECG, electrocardiogram. But these devices will not have any control over the variable, because this, if you take a ECG, it just monitoring the heart rate, but it cannot have any control on the heart rate. And some other examples also we can say here, and they are digital CRO, digital millimeter, logic analysis, etc. These are used in control and instrumentation applications. So one of the embedded application for monitoring purposes, ECG. The important thing is it cannot have any control on the variables. Next one is, fifth one is control. Embedded systems with control functionalities impose control over some variables according to the changes in the input variable. These kind of embedded applications will be having sensors and actuators. But in the previous one, in the monitoring, here also sensors will be there, only sensors will be there. Okay, so to have control over the variables which sensor or which input it receives, for that we should have actuators. Okay, so in these embedded systems with the control functionality, all these type of embedded applications will be having sensors as well as actuators. So what sensor will do? Sensor will be connected with the input port of the device, and it will receive the input from the environmental variables or measuring variables as the input, and whatever it receiving, it will be sent to the actuator side. So this actuators will be connected in the output port, are controlled, connected to the changes in input variable. So according to the input it received from the sensor, it will control the variables. So it can have the control over the variable. So now the example of an embedded system with control is air conditioner system. Okay, so in air conditioner, a sensor will be there that will sense the room temperature. So according to this room temperature, and the air conditioner temperature will be set automatically. So that, for that, actuator is used here. So in the input side, sensor is connected that is used to sense the room temperature. According to the room temperature, the data will be automatically changed inside the air conditioner, so that room temperature will be automatically changed. Room temperature will be automatically changed based on the input it got from the sensor. Next one is application specific user interface. This is the last one. These are embedded systems with application specific user interface, like buttons, switches, keypads, lights, bells, display units, etc. Example, we can say mobile phones. Thank you.